The sister of Commission on Higher Education Chair Prospero de Vera has been arrested for alleged involvement in communist terrorist operations. Adora de Vera, a martial law survivor, is accused of being an officer in the Communist Party. She's facing multiple murder and rebellion charges. CHED Chair de Vera distancing himself from his sister. In a statement, he said he has not seen her for more than 25 years. He stressed that he does not share the views of his sister, but that he is praying for her well-being. Adora de Vera was among 10 other martial law survivors who filed and won a historic case against the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. in a federal district court of Pennsylvania. Philippine government's purchase of allegedly overpriced laptops front and center at the Senate Blue Ribbon Probe Thursday. Senators grilled former education and budget officials over the 2.4 billion peso project flagged by the Commission on Audit in its 2021 report. There were heated exchanges as officials denied their involvement in the procurement.
Hindi ko sinabing ako nag-approve. Ang sinabi namin, nagbigay ang PSDBM ng action slip na
yes.
Kinongkor ng ICTA.
Nahawa ko yung dokumento. A certain Abram Abanil na nandiyan sa harap. Pakitaas yung kamay mo. Kailangan dalawa nag-aprubahan ito.
Hindi, Your Honor. Wala akong pangalan dyan, Your Honor.
May papeles tayo rito.
Wala akong pangalan dyan, Your Honor.
Pagkutaasan ang boses mo.
Yes,
kaya
Your Honor.
Kaya tayo may microphone dito. You don't have to the right to elevate the modulation of your voice. Naririnig ka namin. Huwag mo kami sigawan.
Also present during the hearing, Lloyd Christopher Lau, the former head of the Budget Department's procurement service, which was also embroiled in the farming controversy at the height of the pandemic. He offered a possible reason why units supposedly budgeted at 35,000 pesos each were purchased at a higher price. But Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, however, was not buying Lau's explanation.
Although there's disparity in the technical specification, there are also add-ons in the requirement of DepEd, yung warranty, mga servicing software. I'm not familiar with that. So I think that's the reason why when they conducted it, medyo ang alam ko tumaas kasi on 2020 and 2021, naubos po ang laptop ng PSDBM because all agencies were requesting for laptop. Also, in the market, nagkaubusan ng laptop.
I'm very sure it's honest corruption.
Between the two agencies.
Meron collusion dito kasi nga pareho naman may IT background, pareho naman may IT expertise. Bakit pumayag?
Despite this controversy, Cayetano believes the PSDBM should not be abolished, as other lawmakers have called for, but he says those responsible for problematic purchases should be made accountable.
Former Education Secretary Leonor Briones, also present in the Senate probe, she defended her former agency's move to tap the PSDBM for the procurement of the laptops. Briones emphasized DepEd had its hands full at that time, due to the pandemic and needed help in purchasing the laptops that were supposed to be used for online classes. Senate Blue Ribbon Chairman Francis Tolentino believes Briones was unaware of any possible irregularity in the contract.
Sa ngayon, sa nakikita ko na medyo naawa tayo sa matanda, parang wala. Sa akin lang yun, ha? Hindi to konklusyon ng committee. Kasi nga, yung umpisa pa lang, sinabi ko parang naikutan kayo ng inyong mga abogado.
Tolentino says the next stage of the probe on the laptop's purchase would call on the joint venture suppliers and other suppliers who failed to secure the bid.